Hello everyone and welcome back to Tiago Forte Week, where on the second video we're actually going to be diving into Tiago's Things3 account. He uses it for task management. I'm quite excited because I've seen screenshots on Twitter, but I've not actually seen it. So this is going to be exciting for me as well. This is a week dedicated to sort of concepts, so you can check out all the other videos in the link in the description. Tiago, good to have you again. Carry on our conversation.
yeah, I'm excited for this. I don't think I've ever shown my things, like the actual system that I'm using, on video anywhere.
Yeah, we're getting exclusives, aren't we? The next one's going to be exclusive. It's going to be perfect. I'm excited because I've seen like a lot of emoji use. I've seen like a lot of project use, and like Things3 is a pretty attractive application. So feel free to jump in whenever suitable.
Sure. If I share my screen, will people be able to see it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Should be perfect.
Yeah, so before I show you, and I want to kind of full disclosure, I didn't clean up or sanitize or censor anything about my task manager. I wanted you to see, like, right before this call, what was I looking at? How was I planning my day and my week? Okay. So there may be some, it may be a bit messy or have, yeah. You know, I don't even know what's there, but
before just shout if you want me to blur out stuff, right?
I'll let you know.
Okay.
And I want to say a few things about Things. Things is just the most amazing productivity app. Mm-hmm. I've been using it since like 2012 or so. That's been a good 7 years. And I only tried one or two task managers before it. And once I found it, I was like, this is it. I'm done. And I've never considered, you know, moving to anything else.
Yeah.
And I think I know a bit about why that is. So it's extremely minimalistic, extremely well designed. And I think there's something about that it's made by a German company. I believe they're based in Berlin. I have lived the past until recently in Silicon Valley near San Francisco. So I get the Silicon Valley mindset where it's like constant new features. Like there's this demand for every couple months you have to be releasing something. And I actually really don't like that. I want my productivity apps for the most part to stay the same, to not be constantly trying new things. And the cultured code team, which is the company that makes it, they do release new features, but they release them all at once and like every few years.
Yeah.
Right? So every like 3 years, I have to completely get used to a new thing, but it's worth it because it's so well thought out. Like, you know, even after all these years, I still discover little details like in the settings or like little ways that things are designed that are just beautifully crafted. It feels like craftsmanship, you know?
Yeah.
And that's why I just support them and love them. But let me kind of jump in here.
Yeah.
So I think many of these apps are quite similar. I mean, there's not that many ways to organize large amounts of text. There's a sidebar over here, which you can hide, which is useful, right? In the midst of execution, you don't want to see all this stuff. You want to see just one window. So you can close that. It's kind of like closing a drawer when you don't want you don't want to see all the crap in the drawer. And then the sidebar is organized a few different ways. So at the very top, you have the inbox. And the inbox is just like any other program. You save things and they're captured there. The way something gets into the inbox, the most usual way, is the single most brilliant feature of Things, which is just, I love, is the quick capture window, which looks like this. Okay.
It's gorgeous.
So there's a keyboard shortcut, control spacebar, and this little thing fades into view. It's especially useful when you're looking at, say, an email or a website, right? Like it's amazing when you're looking at your email or a website, even just switching to a different application is very jarring, right? Like completely changing your whole visual landscape is jarring. So I like that this thing comes up on top of whatever you're doing. And then you can just write, you know, I'll say, send Francesco links to my website and social media. And then hit enter, and then it's just gone, right? There's no, you can't, if you saw in the window, you can say which project this goes to, like how it should be organized, the tags. I say just don't do any of that. And then the task shows up right here in my inbox. And you can see, I mean, this is like from 1 or 2 days, all day long, I am what's called capturing open loops, right? All day long, there's little things coming up. And I don't have to even barely pause what I'm doing. I can just capture them in moments. And that's the inbox. One cool thing, I think I'll show you one more thing. So if you're looking at a web page, and this works with email too, you can do Control Option Spacebar, which is a slight modification, and it will automatically sense the URL that you're looking at, and it will put it here in the notes. And that right there, like, you cannot imagine how useful that is, especially for email, right? You know, when you have that email lingering in your inbox like forever, and it never goes away, this could be just a simple way to capture what you actually need to do. And then it will have a link to the email, and then you hit save, and then you can archive that email from your inbox.
Yeah, that's it. Amazing. And how do you go about using the project side of stuff? Because obviously, that's quite a hidden feature, I think, because you don't get it straight away. It's pre-built, and you spend a lot of time in it, right?
The projects here, you mean?
Yes.
Yeah, so this is the, if you're familiar with GTD, which is really kind of how I started getting things done, the project list is like your dashboard, yeah. Right? Like, you know, when you're driving a car, you need to see just a few dials, like what is happening right now. This is the project list that I use. And it is a built-in feature of things. You click here on the bottom left, and then it says new project. And then I can say video with Francesco. And then if I want, I could add an emoji at the beginning, and then it pops up right here. And actually, this is a bit of a hack, but Things expects you to save each project underneath an area like this.
Yeah.
So then you can say, okay, what's in content? Click the arrow, and there it is. I don't like that because it basically spreads out the project so much that I can't see them at a glance.
Yeah.
So most of my projects, I just keep in one list at the very top.
Oh yeah.
Where did that go? Like this. So then in one window, I can see them. There are a few exceptions. Like if there's something assigned to my executive assistant, then I move the project under him. If there's something that's like a blog project, like a series of blog posts, I'll keep that under this area, which is, my blog, which is called Praxis. So there are some exceptions, but for the most part, I like keeping them here. And this means that I can just, you know, if I'm working on this workshop that I'm teaching soon in LA, I can just click it and see only the small set of tasks that are related to that one project.
Okay, that's really interesting. And I see that, like, you've got a lot of later projects. Is that because you've scheduled them for a later period of time, just sort of minimized them, right? So that, like, you've always, like, pre-scheduled everything in advance.
You know, this is a feature I don't use very often. So Things has this thing called Sunday. This is also in line with GTD. Is there's a whole category of Sunday maybe. Things that you want to do Sunday or things that you're not sure you want to do. Yeah. And in this case, these are projects that are Sunday projects. But I think this might have been from the previous version of Things where it kind of like carry them over, because I don't really schedule later or Sunday projects, to be honest.
Amazing. And in terms of like for example, like day to day, do you try to restrict how many tasks you've got inside of your today area or upcoming at any given time? Or how do you go about filtering it as well?
Yeah. So what I would typically do, in fact, I'll show you this too. This is my weekly review.
Okay. Sticky note.
This is, yeah, I like keeping it really simple, really direct. And I just have this kind of pinned somewhere on my desktop. Mm-hmm. It's pretty much memorized now, but sometimes I still refer to it. So really just like once a week, at most twice a week, I'll just go through, completely clear my email inbox, capture anything that needs to actually be done in my Things inbox, like I showed you previously. I check my calendar the last 2 weeks and the next 4 weeks. So I sort of have like a rolling view of everything that I'm doing. I clear my physical inbox and my paper notebook of anything to do, any open loops. my computer desktop, my downloads, my budgets, my Evernote. By that time, I have maybe 30 to 50 new open loops in my things inbox. Like, it's amazing how many new things are created each week. At that point, I prioritize them just high or medium. I only have two priorities. Put them into their projects, review anything that I'm waiting for, review my photos, and then I choose my today tasks. And the cool thing about this is, like, if you were to try to do this first, it just wouldn't work. Because you'd be like, oh, but I have something in my images. Oh, no, something in Evernote. Oh, I need to review my budgets. Like, you'd have to keep going backwards. Having done all these nine steps means my today selection is easy. It's so easy. All I do is I go here to the full list of tasks, say priority high. So these are only things I've set are high priority, and there's usually only 10 to 20.
Yeah, yeah.
Right? And then from these, like, let's say I want to do this week or today. I kind of use today as this week more. It's like things I'm doing over the next week. I just do Command T. It adds this little star right here, and then that appears in my today list. And so over the course of the week, this is really my to-do list that I'm slowly working my way through, yeah. Right? My to-do list isn't all these. Like, there's probably several hundred tasks in all of these projects and areas. That can't be your to-do list. That's completely overwhelming. The actual list that you work from can be 5 to 10 items at most.
Yeah. And like, in terms of what I quite like about that is actually that you sort of write out your task in a very different style. It's like almost like written out, like you're saying it, if you know what I mean. Yeah. I quite like that. Yeah, that's really smart. And you've combined the emoji use. For example, let's say you're like trying to drill down inside that today area. Do you use those filters then, or do you just strictly use the anytime?
You know, I've tried to use those tags so much. A strict GTD would be something like contexts, right? Yeah. You'd have tags for like at the office, in the car, grocery store, off, you know, things like that. What I find is that my life is so, I'm such a digital nomad where I can, in theory, do anything at any time. You know, I could be writing my book in the checkout line of the supermarket. Now, just because I can do that, does that mean I should?
Yeah.
Right? So I find context is really not so helpful anymore now that we have these devices. So for me, the context that matters more is my state of mind. Am I in the state of mind to actually start this and finish it? Do I have all the information I need? Is my mood and my energy level kind of ready for this? And to me, that's a decision that can never be fully automated. I have to make it on a case by case basis. What this list allows me to do is make that decision in the moment as easily and quickly as possible.
Yeah.
Right. Instead of selecting from hundreds, I'm selecting from 10.
I think the thing that I would take away from the short list you had, because what I typically do is I do probably what you do as your number 10 is I organize my today first and then go and process everything and then realize I've got a lump of other stuff to go and process for this week. So I feel like I need to role reversal, like go back and do that sort of process. That was really helpful. How obviously, like, you plan on continuing to use things through you just in the future? Like, there's no plans to stop?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I mean, it's just, it really is second nature to me. I mean, it takes no energy. You know, capturing these little quick tasks throughout the day is like completely a habit. So as long as they don't make any huge mistakes, or I don't know, sometimes a new generation of software comes along that doesn't have like more features, but a whole new way of thinking.
Yeah.
And that's usually the one time I will make that jump is when there's a new piece of software that's a completely different paradigm. And that jump is what justifies all of the work of moving.
Yeah, that's it. Brilliant. Tiago, where can everyone find you?
I'm most active on Twitter at Forte Labs. That's also my website, fortelabs.co.co, which has links to my online courses, such as Building a Second Brain, which is the main one. Has links to my ebooks, my workshops, my speaking. And I'd love to hear from your subscribers.
Amazing. Thank you so much for showing us into things three. We're going to now jump over and chat about Notion. So that's going to be quite exciting. If you're a Notion fan, you should definitely stay around for that conversation. I will see you in a sec, Tiago.
Okay.
Awesome.